We are still looking for more information. We're still trying to build that picture, just like we have stated all along. We're putting all the pieces together.
This is not the end of this investigation. In fact, this is a new beginning.
Today's press conference was thin on details and left us with a lot of questions. One thing we're hearing a lot about, though, is DNA evidence. My next guest is an expert on the topic, former Sacramento County DA Anne Marie Schubert. She joins me now. So, Anne Marie, good to see you. What role do you
Thanks so much. You're welcome.
It's good to see you. What role do you think DNA played in breaking this case and the arrest that happened today?
Well, let me first by saying that I don't have any direct knowledge, but, you know, obviously there's a lot of information out there about the possibility that DNA was collected in this case. And I think, you know, just talking generically, I am quite confident DNA can play a very critical role, and genetic genealogy can also play a very critical role in ultimately identifying who was responsible for this crime.
You know, you look at a crime like this, and it was brutal, and it appeared that the victims had defensive wounds. So I can't imagine that Kohlberger would have not left some DNA behind. The question becomes, were investigators able to retrieve it? Did they find the spare hair? Did they find the drop of blood or perspiration that could have been left behind? How has technology developed that will allow investigators to suck up all of this DNA and analyze it?
Well, my experience comes from long years of DNA, but really when you look at like the Golden State Killer and the way that that case was solved, that was a case that, you know, the guy killed 13 people, raped over 50. And ultimately, after 40 years of an investigation, it was genetic genealogy that ultimately solved that case in about 60 days. And so when we talk about this new tool of genetic genealogy, it is the most revolutionary thing we've seen in our lifetime, and perhaps that we're going to see for many, many years to come. That's why it becomes such a critical piece, not just for cold cases, but as in this particular case, if in fact it was used, that for active cases, that this is now has the ability that we can solve upwards maybe of 90% of crimes if we in fact have DNA left at a crime scene. It's incredible, revolutionary tool that we now have.
You know, Anne Marie, I was a prosecutor for 10 years myself, and so many people watch these crime shows, and they all expect DNA evidence or fingerprint evidence, and you don't often get that in many crimes that we prosecute. If they don't have that there, do you think the jury in Idaho, if this goes to trial, is going to expect that they have DNA evidence, or do you think juries today will rely on the evidence that prosecutors actually have?
Well, I have faith in the prosecution that you can't file a case unless you believe you can prove it beyond a reasonable doubt. And so I, you know, yes, a lot of times juries want to see that kind of evidence, but not every case has to have it. But, you know, setting that aside from this particular case, you know, we have to go back to the fact that when we talk about the advancements of science, you know, 10 years ago, what we could find at a crime scene is very, very different than what we see now. We have the ability now to get DNA profiles from rootless hairs. We have the ability to get DNA from somebody touching a glass. So we have advanced to the point that we are really, as I say, the greatest revolutionary digital age of DNA that we have ever seen in our lifetimes. It's very exciting to be part of. It's also something that we have to, you know, be very, very aggressive about and making sure that all of our law enforcement partners are aware of it. How does it work? Getting our public laboratories to utilize it, and also getting the general public to opt into such places as Family Tree DNA and GEDmatch, because we need, if we're going to use genetic genealogy, we need people to opt in and share their DNA in those public sites.
Anne Marie, it is fascinating technology. And listen, thanks for joining me and thanks for your insights. Appreciate it.
Thanks so much for having me, Sean.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.